Your finger gets a burn when you touch a vessel heated by the gas stove. But when you boil water on an induction stove, the vessel does not burn your hands. But why? Does the induction stove heat only the water? Why isn't the vessel hot? Does an induction stove emit microwaves? How is an induction stove different from a microwave oven? This is what we are going to discuss in this video. First, let us look into the principle behind the working of an induction stove, electromagnetic induction. When alternating current flows through a coil, the magnitude and direction of the magnetic field around it varies. When you bring another coil near this varying magnetic field, an alternating voltage is induced across its ends. This phenomenon of inducing a current flow in a secondary coil due to the varying magnetic field created by the primary coil is called electromagnetic induction. Transformers, wireless chargers, etc. are applications of electromagnetic induction. Now, instead of a coil, if a metal plate is brought near the varying magnetic field, eddy current is formed in the plate. This flow of eddy current heats up the plate. This is termed as eddy current heating or induction heating. In an induction stove, a high frequency alternating current flows through a coil beneath the cooktop. Induction bottom cookware are usually steel vessels with a bottom plate thickness of more than 1.5 mm. When these vessels are placed on the induction stove, eddy current is induced in the bottom plate. This eddy current heats up the bottom of the vessel. Water in the vessel is heated by convection. Thus, the induction stove does not heat the water inside the vessel directly. Induction heating is extremely low at the rim of the vessel as they are far from the coil. The sides of the vessel heats up due to conduction through the vessel and convection through the water inside. Why does a vessel kept on a gas flame heat up more? The reason is that there is another kind of heating in addition to those discussed above. In a gas stove, the flame heats the bottom of the vessel and the hot products of combustion move up along the sides of the vessel. In addition, since the air around the burner is also heated, a convective heating occurs onto the sides of the vessel. Hence, there is a higher amount of heat transferred to the vessel and our finger burns upon touching it. Now, let us understand the difference between an induction stove and a microwave oven. Microwave radiations are hazardous to health and interfere with the operation of other electronic gadgets. Hence, microwave heating happens within a closed oven. Thus, an induction stove, being an open cooktop, does not use microwave heating. Water molecules in food vibrate when the high-frequency microwave radiations fall on them. These high-frequency vibrations generate heat. This heat cooks the food kept inside a microwave oven. Thus, microwave heating heats up the food directly. This is why even a glass bowl can be used to heat food in a microwave oven. When we cook food in a microwave oven, the microwave radiations heat the moisture content in the food directly. Due to this uniform direct heating, the insides remain hotter than outside. This is the reason many delicacies cooked in a microwave oven appear warm outside but burns our tongue when we take a bite into them. I hope you will remember this fact when you feast on your favorite pizza just out of the oven. I hope you have understood the difference between induction cooking, gas flame cooking and microwave cooking. Please like and share this video if you find it interesting. Do subscribe to our channel But Why. I will see you with another informative video next week.